are four underground stations: Boggo Road, Woolloongabba, Albert Street, and Roma Street.
On Cross River Rail in particular, one of the key complexities that I think is actually just the locality. We're building in an urban environment where we've got, you know, residents and sensitive stakeholders and the road network directly adjacent to our site. Also, just the physical real estate that's available for our construction teams for lay down between cranes and lay down area for steel and workshops and water treatment plants, real estate is prime.
Boggo Road Station is a really intricate and complex station, as with all of the Cross River Rail stations.
Different construction techniques have been used across the different stations due to the locality in some instances or the alignment, that's the geometry of the rail. So for example, at Boggo Road Station, the reason we had to use the canopy tube system, the umbrella system, is because the cavern's actually located directly under the Park Road rail line. So we just don't have the depth of material above to that rail line to physically put in anchors. The canopy tubes, it forms an umbrella essentially, and it's just referring to the shape and that support type. Our cavern there actually directly adjoins our station box, so once the station box was excavated to a certain level, they could actually use cranes to lift in the equipment and then start our tunnel works.
The new Cross River Rail Woolloongabba station is located adjacent to the existing busway and just opposite to the Gabba Stadium. Woolloongabba station facilitated the launching of the two tunnel boring machines that we had last year, and it made the year of the tunneling possible. During construction, particularly for the Woolloongabba station, once the tunneling has been done and then the north cavern and the south cavern has been constructed, then moving on to the station box itself. The temporary facilities, for example, the decliner that already exists at Galway Station, that has facilitated removal of a lot of spoil and excavated material from the tunnel areas. And now that area needs to be basically backfilled and for future works to be enabled on top of that area there.
Excavation of the four underground stations is completed, which has unlocked the next stage of construction. These underground stations are a hive of activity, with crews underground working around the clock.
Albert Street comprises of the actual three sites. So our two key sites is Lot 1 and Lot 2. So they're on the corner of Albert Street and Mary Streets. And we do have a third site, Lot 3. Differences from all the other sites is purely the size of the site compared to, say, the Gabba site and Roma Street. We're a much more constrained site. Got, you know, a number of tall residential towers overlooking our site. You know, where we're digging in Lot 1, we're digging, I suppose, the biggest hole in the CBD. We're going to be 45, almost 50 metres deep at the deepest point in Lot 1. Having two residential towers, 150 metre tall towers sitting next to us, just understanding that geotech and being able to provide a design to adequately support the ground, one of those crucial things to understand and be across before for any successful dig in the CBD.
The excavation of Albert Street was completely different compared to the other underground stations. Because the ground conditions were incredibly hard in the station location, a stage process was used, with excavation by road headers and blasting before the TBMs passed through the half-excavated cavern. After the TBMs passed underneath, excavation continued to fully open up the station, allowing us to get started on the permanent lining and fit-out process.
The Roma Street station, I think, will really transform this area of the city. I think it's also really going to open up the city, you know, as we look forward to new infrastructure coming in, as well as the Olympics in 2032.
So to get to this point, we're actually standing right underneath the old Roma Street railway station. So we had to sink a shaft, and we had to tunnel in with road headers to open up a mine tunnel, and then slowly excavate the cavern. First the heading, and then take out the benches.
In terms of complexities on this job, for the excavation portion, our biggest challenge was making sure we got the cavern excavated and ready to receive the TBMs when they were barreling down from Woolloongabba. So that was really our biggest challenge. And, you know, we hit quite a few complexities along the way in terms of the ground conditions. The rock we encountered was probably much harder than we ever anticipated. Underground, we've got waterproofing, steel fixing, assembling bespoke formwork systems, and doing thousands of cubic metres of concrete while a myriad of different trades are happening in an enclosed space, and all the while managing all these logistics to get through to these other work fronts.
A lot goes into building this project, but as these stations begin to rise out of the ground, we're starting to see the results of all the hard work that's gone into getting us to this point. We've had to solve some really big challenges, but that's what it takes to complete a mega project like this.